Well, good afternoon, friends, and happy Vlogmas Day 2. Today is Monday, the 2nd of December, and we are on to the second day in Vlogmas. So today I thought I would do my annual Christmas goodies haul with you all. I know that this won't be all of the things that I will be buying this Christmas that are Christmassy, apart from like presents and things, but this is just what I have at the moment. There are things in this huge bag full of just stuff that I want to be using now, so I want to sort of do this haul so then I can use things throughout the month. So I have my big bag here that I usually use to fill all my Christmas stuff. So there's my big Christmas stuff bag, and it's chock full of stuff. I've actually kind of forgot what half of the stuff in the bag is, so we'll discover together. I think that's the most exciting way to do it. So as I go, I will tell you where I got things from. If I can remember prices or they have prices on them, I'll let you know, because I know that you guys do like me telling you what I paid for things, because you guys live in other countries and things. It's always nice to compare. Without further ado, let's see what I got this year for Christmas. Oh, geez, I don't know where to start. I think we'll start with TK Maxx. Either unfortunately or very fortunately, or really dangerously, have a TK Maxx store in the same center as our Spotlight store. So, you know, I love shopping there, what can I say? So they always have some really great like seasonal stuff. And at the moment they have so much Christmas stuff, it's crazy. So of course I picked stuff up. Let's start off with a few things I want to put on the Christmas tree. These were everywhere when we were shopping in London, but they were really expensive. So I don't know who made these or what brand they are, whether they're like knockoffs or the real thing. I got no idea. But I picked up these set of two. Hopefully it will focus. There you go. Set of two Christmas decorations. And they're made out of that like that felt velvety stuff, like my other ones that I showed you in my UK haul, and they're all decorated and embroidered and stuff. So for the two of them, I paid $8.95. So that was like $4.50 each. When we're in London, each of these might have cost like £12, which was like $25. So that is a bargain if they are like the real thing. But they will be going on the tree later this afternoon. I picked up some beautiful cards. These are by, I'll try and get that glare off it. These are by a company called Clementine Paper Inc. And there are 16 cards and envelopes in there. And I'm pretty sure it's all just the same design. I thought that was a really nice design. So, love a good Christmas card. And then I got some beautiful Ray Dunn gift tag stickers. I think that's focused, I can't quite see, but I really liked these stickers because there was actually room to write names and things. Sometimes the stickers are so tiny, you can barely even write anything. So I do like that there is room on these ones to actually write something. Oh, this is what was making the bag so heavy. Candles. I picked up two different candles. I think, I'm not sure whether this one actually is Christmassy or not. It was just with all the Christmas stuff, I think, because it was just green. This is by a company called Sand and Fog, and it is in the scent Huckleberry. I got no idea what a huckleberry is or what it's supposed to smell like, but this one apparently smells like it. Now to me it smells like sweet, sweet fairy floss. Fairy floss is what we call candy floss, and it just smells sickly sweet and sugary and just lovely. That was $12.95, and it's got a really nice sort of fancy lid on there. I just really like that. So huckleberry, that one. And then the other candle I got, this one is Christmas. It's called Vanilla Cream, and it just smells so much like my childhood, and I can't pinpoint it. Oh, it smells like vanilla cookies or vanilla biscuits or something. Reminds me of my childhood because my dad was a baker at Arnott's Biscuits. And he would always come home with his hands smelling so sweet of just freshly baked biscuits and stuff like that. So I think that's what it reminds me of, like Tiny Teddies. Australians will know what I'm talking about. The the Honey Tiny Teddies, how they have that really nice sweet vanilla-y scent. That's what it reminds me of. This one was $5.95 and I'm actually really quite excited to burn that one because vanilla scents always remind me very much of Christmas. I was going to get some batteries for this one and we're going to test it together. I can do it afterwards, that's fine. But I picked up, I only got this the other day, I got this really lovely light up Christmas tree. So it's like a porcelain or something breakable. And then it's got a little thing in the bottom where you can put some batteries and it lights up. So I'm really excited about that. I just really loved the color of it. And it just has this really lovely sort of texture in it. I just thought it was really, really nice. So later on, I will find some batteries and we will test this together and see if it actually works. I hope it does. I just sort of took a chance. I was like, ah. I will save the paper for when it's time to pack it away. It's safe. And for that tree, I paid $19.95, $20. So that's why I'm hoping it works, because otherwise it's 20 bucks down the drain. Let's do a couple of things from Spotlight. I got this iron-on motif. It's iron-on transfer type thing. And it's of a car with presents on it. So I wasn't sure, again, whether to like buy like a really cheap shirt and then just iron that onto the front and have a nice lovely Christmas shirt. This one was $4. I think I got it when it was like 20% off or 30% off. Oh, that's not the right receipt for it. And then for the kids, I got these shrink art decorations. So there's two different sorts and you color them in and then you put them in the oven and they shrink down and then you can make them into like key rings and stuff like that. So one of my friends at work said she does this with her grandchildren and they love it. So she's like, you should do it with your kids. Well, not my kids because I don't have kids, but you know, my little people. So if they come over anytime during the month, I'll get them out and we can do them together. I've got a bit of a frog in my throat today. it is a little bit hazy outside today. So I don't know whether it's that. I don't know. It is what it is. And also the sun keeps coming in and out of the clouds. That's why now we're nice and bright. Soon we'll go back into darkness. So just excuse that. All right, so moving on to a few things I got from Kmart. Oh, I hope I just didn't do something to them. I got some Christmas tins. Around Christmas I make so much stuff, like food stuff. Like I bake a lot. I do a ton of gingerbread. I do Rocky Road and lots of other sort of sweet bits and bobs, and I never have any Christmas tins to put them in. I think I have one. And then if you guys remember from maybe maybe it was 2017, a couple of years ago, I have a ceramic Colin the Koala cookie jar. I use him as well, but I just find that it's just not enough. So I found these really great Christmas tins at Kmart. They were really cheap. I don't know how much they actually were. I think they were like maybe like $5 or something. Actually, I might open it, have a look. Okay, so I've just taken the plastic off. It took me forever. Came with the big tin with Santa and an elf on it. Oh, and a gingerbread man. Oh, that's cute. And then on the inside, oh geez, I don't want to get into it. Oh, whoa, more packaging. Oh my goodness. And then, oh, there's another tiny little tin with a reindeer on it. How cute is that? Geez, I am so aware of just how much packaging stuff comes in. It's ridiculous. There's the other little tin. Oh, I really like this one. I love the color of this tin. It's super cute. And it's got all the reindeer around the edges. It's a close-up of the other one. And then that one's just got that around the edges. Oops. So, that's my Christmas tins from Kmart. The other thing from Kmart is just some Christmas towels. Just either for the bathroom or for the kitchen. This one says Merry Christmas on it. It's embroidered Merry Christmas. And then the other one's just a spotty towel you can kind of use all year. And I think these are about $5 as well. A few things from Target. This cute, gorgeous little guy. Look at him. He's so adorable. So it's Christmas tree, obviously. Christmas tree plushie. And he's got a hard bottom so that he can either sit on a shelf or on the lounge or anywhere. And his little cute little feet dangle, and Yeah, and apparently he's supposed to smell like pine. It's very, very vague. Not all that great, but I just thought he was the most adorable little thing, and I'm going to put him on the lounge in the front room where I usually take up space. So that's where he's going to go. I wonder if he'll sit there for the rest of the video. Are you going to sit there, sweetheart? There. I paid $12 for him. Cute! One other thing I got from Target is this cute little succulent plant with Santa on it. I mean, it's fake, as you do. But I just really liked the little pot. They did have one with a reindeer on it, Rudolph on it, but a lot of them were broken. This was kind of like the only one that didn't look awful or broken or chipped or had anything wrong with it. So I just got the Santa. I'm not sure how much I paid for him. It would have been under $10, between $5 and $10. I would have paid for that. Moving on to Big W. I have actually showed you this one. This is my dancing Santa. This guy here. There he is. This is his little face. But yeah, this is one of the first Christmassy things I got once I got back from the UK. And he is a dancing Santa. He shuffles back and forth. I'll do a little video for you and I'll insert it now. When I first tried it in the store, I thought it was the coolest thing. It made me laugh, it made me happy, so I picked him up. Why not? And I paid $15 for him. I got this beautiful Mickey decoration from Big W. It's a black Mickey head and it's just all glittery and lovely. I thought he was pretty cool. So that's another thing that can go on the tree this afternoon. And I think this one, it's $5. Maybe about that, roughly. Also from Big W, I'm the most excited about these, I think. I got some Minnie and Mickey Mouse Christmas earrings. It's also got the holly and berry leaves up here. This one's Minnie Mouse and then Mickey Mouse, and these were $8. I cannot wait to wear these. Oh, I just thought they were the cutest thing ever. Then I also got one of these scrunchies. Scrunchies are so popular at the moment, and it's a Minnie Mouse, so Minnie Mouse bottom here. You've got the ears and a little bow so that when you actually put it in like a top bun, you'll have like the ears sticking up like that. This one was $10. I was like, oh, $10. Just get it. Two other things I got from Spotlight that I missed out on were these two little brooches, a tree and a wreath. And they were $5. I got them for half price, which at $2.50 each. So one of them I'm going to keep and then one I'll give to my mum. I think I'm going to have the wreath because I love Christmas wreaths, hence why I'm doing an embroidery and they're everywhere in our house. And plus this one is silver. I only ever really wear silver jewelry. This one's gold. Mum wears a lot of gold stuff, so I think that's how it's going to go. This one I showed in a vlog a little while ago, and I got this from a home interior store. I think it was called Habitat or something like that. And they were doing like this big sale, so I got this sign that says Noel on it and it's all like beaded and stuff. I got this for $7.50. It was usually $25. And then from that store I also picked up these really cool napkins. They're very Australiana. These ones are $1.90 each, usually $10. And it's got people lounging on the beach, a little koala. It's got a kangaroo on the back there. This one has a Santa on it, and just people at the beach enjoying Christmas in Australia, which is pretty much how life is here in Australia. I mean, we don't go to the beach on Christmas Day, but a lot of people do, so I thought they were very, very cool. So before I move on to the Christmas London things, I mean, you've seen them all before, but I'm going to show you anyway, again. I'll do a couple of nerdy purchases that I bought because you know how much of a geek I am. I love just geek and pop culture and stuff. I Oh my gosh, this is the sweetest thing ever, I think. It just, oh my gosh, just makes me so happy just looking at it. I think you all know how much I love Pusheen. Pusheen is that little kawaii cat. And I found this beautiful fluffy Pusheen wreath that has Pusheen in the middle with a little Christmas hat and a scarf. It's got this gorgeous little cat bell. And yeah, she's just inside this beautiful plushy wreath and it's just gorgeous. I love the pastel colors and just how cute and like niche and ridiculous it is. I just love it. I think I paid about $30 for this. So, I mean, you know, Pusheen merch is expensive anyway. So, these things I do for the things I love. So, cute. I think I'm going to put this on my sewing room door because why not? One fun thing that I got that I thought we would do during Vlogmas as well, and we can track progress and stuff like that, is a wonderful Disney puzzle. Yay! This one is the Ravensburger one. It's 1,000 pieces and it just has a really beautiful Disney scene on as the design. So we'll be cracking that out in the next couple of days and we'll get it started, and I'm pretty sure we'll get it done by Christmas Day because not only do I love doing puzzles, my mum loves doing puzzles. If you leave her alone with the box of pieces, she will literally do it in a day, I think. So I'm gonna have to tell her, don't hog it, you know. We all want to have a turn too. No. Okay. Don't worry. I'm joking. My mum knows that I'd be joking if I ever said that to her. But yeah, we'll share the load and we'll do that together. And hopefully I can track the progress of us doing that. And then the other thing that's geeky that we're going to build together and stuff, I'll possibly do this with my brother. I remember last year I did a crafts video with my brother Graham. I'm gonna rope him in and do this together because we both love Star Wars. And it's a Star Wars build your own Millennium Falcon, like gingerbread sugar cookie thing. I don't know. I got this at Woolworths, which is one of our big supermarkets here. It's just a kit that has all of these pieces in it already and you just assemble it into the Millennium Falcon. So I don't know how well we're gonna go. I had a very notorious disaster building a gingerbread house years ago. I've never done it again because it was just such a failure. So I'm hoping that this isn't going to be any harder than that. But, you know, we'll see what happens. We'll see how we go. Well, let's move on to all of my Christmas goodies that I got in the UK. Actually, they're all from London. All of my London decorations. Just gonna tell you now, you have seen all of these already if you have watched my UK souvenirs haul. So if you don't want to see them again, you can skip ahead. I don't mind, that's fine. But if you wanted to see me quickly go through them again, then stay, please. I'd love you to. Let's start with the things that are actually gonna go on the tree. There are a few things that won't be because they're too fragile. My little London bus and my London guard. These guys live in my sewing room, but they will be going on the tree because they are not breakable, because our floor in the kitchen is tiles and concrete. So anything breakable falls, it will die. Which is why my beautiful Harrods dome will not be going on the tree. This is going back in the display cabinet that we have. But this is the little decoration I got from Harrods, and it just has a London scene in it along with the Harrods building. And it says Harrods on it, and this I paid £13 for, again, which is why it's not going on the Christmas tree, because £13 is expensive. A couple of things from Liberty, of course. I have this bauble here that says Liberty, and it has all of the beautiful holly leaves and the holly berries on it. This one I paid £7.95, I think. I'm still quite wary of that one, but I will be careful. I'll put that in a place on the tree where if the tree gets knocked, it will be safe. It'll be okay. And then the other one from Liberty is the beautiful Liberty heart that has the storefront on it. And it's the same on the back. This one was $8.95 £8.95. I think that's how you say it, right? Another thing that I got from Harrods is the 2019 bauble with the Union Jack on it. This one I paid £10 for. I think, again, I'll put this one somewhere safe on the tree where it should be okay. And then last but not least, a nice lovely geeky thing to end on is my two Harry Potter decorations that I got from Primark. These were £5, £2.50 each. We've got Harry and then the Marauder's Map. I'm actually not sure what they're made out of. I'm not sure whether they're actually breakable or not. But again, I'll put them somewhere where they're safe and hopefully won't die. So like I mentioned, at the moment, that is all of my sort of Christmassy things that I've picked up in the last couple of months or so. Don't be surprised if I pick up more during the month. It's just inevitable. It's going to happen because I love Christmas. I love buying Christmassy things and yeah, just being all festive and lovely. So that is my 2019 Christmas goodies haul. I do hope that you enjoyed it. There are still a couple of things we're going to go through. We're going to put some batteries in that tree. We're going to put the decorations on the tree and we also need to do the advent calendar for today. So let's get ourselves organized. So this is what is on my sliding door at the moment. So I'm just going to carefully take that off and then I'm going to hang my beautiful pusheen wreath on the door. Oh, that's so lovely. Yay. I'm really happy with that. Awesome. So I've just discovered something with my little pal here. You know how I said he was scented and I couldn't really quite smell his scent? Sounds disgusting. But there's a little, like, I don't know, thing in here, like a pellet or like a bag of, you know how you have like bags of dried lavender? Well, there's something here at the top and I've just sort of been playing with it. And that's where his scent is. So he smells like pine. It's really quite strong now, so he does smell. You smell good, mate. But I thought I'd just update you that if you yourself have got one of these, if you are in Australia, his smell is at the top of his, at the top of his point. Mm. So we are now ready to go put these little things on the tree. Let's go do it. Whee. This one is Mickey. I'll put him here. There. Very good. Pop our telephone box here at the front. Oh, this one's quite a long one. He doesn't want to dangle. There we go. He looks a bit good there. Mr. Policeman can go here if he wants to untangle. Stop being annoying. He looks quite good there. Let's do the bus. Bus can go here. Bus is next to the pudding. Next, our London soldier. So we got Luke Skywalker there, and then our soldier, and this beautiful reindeer one I have up all the time. It's so adorable. It's all glittery on the back. I love it. He looks very happy in there. Got Liberty next. I'll pop that one there because this one here is the one my mum brought from Liberty, and it's just a beautiful crackled sort of bauble and it's got this beautiful velvet ribbon. So there we go, we've got our two special Liberty ones together. And then my other Liberty one, I will put this one nestle in there. And then what I also do, because it's fake our tree, I just bend the branches up so that they don't come off. But there he is, all nestled in there. Lovely, right near my bus and the pudding. Now I've got to find somewhere for my Harrods. Put him down a little further at the bottom of the tree. I'm just going to open my little Harry Potter ones because I don't know what they're made out of and I'm interested. What are you made out of? Oh, it's like a rubber type thing. There's Harry. He's very cool. And then here's Marauder's Map. So let's find a spot for them on the tree. There he is, nestled in there next to C-3PO. Oh, he's a happy little fella, isn't he? Marauder's Map, I'll pop here to fill in that space. It's not going to face the right way. Of course. There we go. Nice. I'm pretty sure that is our tree
done. I don't think I have to put anything else on there unless I come across things that I've forgotten about.
Okay, so we're back in our favorite spot.
Nice. Okay, so I was able to find some batteries. I don't know whether they're new or old or what. They were just all together like that. So we're gonna see if our little light works. It's really windy outside. We're just gonna watch a few things that we have out there. So let's pop them in. All right, moment of truth. I don't know how well it's gonna work. Ready? Oh, that's not bad. That's gonna look a lot nicer in the dark, I think. Oh, I'm very happy that that works. That's gonna look so nice. I'm very happy with that. Oh, we can get rid of the sticker now. Somehow. So the time of day has come for me to do the advent calendar. If you missed out on me explaining it yesterday, this is the Sew and Quilt and Celebrate Christmas advent calendar by Sewing Quarter. As far as I know, Sewing Quarter is a organization in the UK. I just found this online. I did link it in yesterday's vlog, but unfortunately it's sold out, so I'm very sorry about that if you wanted to get one. So let's see what's in day two. We're gonna find where day two is. So here is day two. Let's see what's in it. Oh, things have fallen. Uh-oh. That is supposed to be in another day, I think. Up you go. This one is a traditional sewing machine pin. Oh, that's cool. Oh, that's super sweet. There it is. Oh, that's really sweet, isn't it? Let's get it out of the packaging. Again, packaging. There's just so much packaging in everything and everywhere. That is so adorable. Oh, wow. Oh, how cute is that? I love it. All right, well, thank you very much for that today, Mr. Calendar. Oh, is an attractive angle. So as I pack up my advent calendar for today, ready for tomorrow, I am going to end today's vlog here. It is only early afternoon, but I filmed a lot in the last couple of hours, and I have a feeling my Christmas goodies haul part of this vlog is going to take up quite a lot of time. So it's going to be a long one, and I'm conscious of how much I need to edit and get done. So thank you very much for joining me today for Vlogmas Day 2. I hope you enjoyed it. And I will see you again tomorrow for Vlogmas Day 3. Yay! This month is going to go so quickly. So quickly. Anyway, see you tomorrow. Bye!